We are in the midst of the Boston Tea Party of our lifetime that will mark the beginning of a global financial revolution. Hello, I'm Crypto Casey, and in this video, we are going to explore how a public online community of retail investors, or regular people like you and I, brought sophisticated professional billionaire investors of Wall Street down to their knees. Specifically, we will discuss what happened, how it happened, the aftermath up to this point in time, the significance of this event, and how it will lead to a massive adoption of a more fair, transparent, equal financial playing field. One that no single person, politician, government, corporation, bank, or entity can control, that anyone on this planet can participate in, thereby creating the first true free global market. We will also talk about what to do if you were affected by Robinhood or another exchange freezing your trading activity this week. By the end of this video, you will understand the situation and its implications for a brighter and better financial future for us all. So, let's start from the top. On the social media platform Reddit, there is an open public community called Wall Street Bets, which consists of a few million people like you and I that discuss investing in the stock market. A person in the community conducted some research and found that huge hedge funds were heavily shorting stocks of certain companies in order to make a profit. So, what is shorting a stock? An investor shorts a stock when they believe the price of the stock will decrease at a future date. And this involves an investor borrowing money to sell that stock with the intention of buying that stock back at a future date for less money. It's a very risky investment strategy where people basically bet on a drop in the stock's price in order to make a profit. Both the profits and the losses from short selling can be quite significant. This is because shorting involves the use of borrowed money, which is why shorting is known as margin trading. So when an investor shorts a stock, they open what's known as a margin account, which is just an account that allows you to borrow money from the brokerage firm. And these margin accounts require a minimum balance to be maintained by the investor. So if the value of the account dips below the minimum balance requirement, the brokerage firm will issue what's called a margin call. And a margin call requires the investor to either add more of their own money to the margin account, or it forces the investor to liquidate or sell all the stock in their account to bring the account balance back to the minimum requirement. So if an investor bets that a company stock is overvalued and bound to decrease at a relatively far out future date, this can create the perfect storm for what's known as a short squeeze. A short squeeze scenario occurs when a short stock begins to increase, which forces short sellers to have to cover their shorted positions by buying them back. And the rise of the stock price may attract the attention of other investors, which would increase the demand for the stock and ultimately drive up the price of the stock. This causes investors with short positions to continue to buy back their positions. New investors buying the stock and short sellers being forced to continue to buy the stock to hedge their losses creates a cycle of the stock price exponentially increasing. And the scenario is a short squeeze. So the person in the Wall Street Bets community who discovered that some big hedge funds had heavily leveraged far out short positions on particular stocks identified a couple of scenarios where a short squeeze could occur if enough investors started buying the stock and increasing the price. The increase in price would cause the hedge funds to have to continuously buy back their short positions, and so long as new investors kept buying and driving up the price, the hedge funds would also have to keep buying the stock, creating that exponential increase in the stock price we described earlier. So, the Wall Street Bets person identified an opportunity to short squeeze the stock, GameStop, and then posted the information about it to the public online Wall Street Bets community. The post piqued a lot of people's interest and gained a lot of attention, and resulted in a ton of the members of the community going in on GameStop stock. And ultimately, they did it. GameStop was the most traded equity on the planet Tuesday with $20 billion in volume. More than the S&P 500, Apple, and even the mighty Tesla. Surreal. And what unfolded thereafter was a short squeeze on GameStop stock, which drove the price up from around $20 to almost $500 in just a few days. And bear in mind, short squeeze is a legitimate scenario in the investment world. I mean, you can read about it on Investopedia here under the Trading Skills and Essentials Trading Basic Education section. Despite its legitimacy as a potential occurrence in our so-called free market, apparently short squeeze is legit until Wall Street gets crushed by Reddit. Then regulators get select trading platforms to stop trading. And these same regulators call new digital assets like Bitcoin funny business? Okay. And why did the regulators step in? Because they're bought and paid for by Wall Street? Check this out. Wall Street is losing its mind after a group of small investors with trading accounts ranging from $500 to $2,500 banded together to take down the billionaires, said Fox Business host Charles Payne. He also explained that these hedge funds selling this stock, they don't own the stock, so they borrow it, Payne explained. Imagine you borrow a stock that's trading at $10, and then you drive the share price down, and then you buy it back for a dollar. You make the difference, $9. They are allowed to short so much stock, he said. Do you know the amount of stock that was out on GameStop? Let's just say 100% of the shares that are out there, they shorted 140% of the stocks. So they borrowed the same stock over and over and over, the same shares, and sold it into the market. So Wall Street, who weren't ever even technically shareholders of GameStop stock, were basically purposefully profiteering off of the company's demise they were manufacturing by destroying the stock price for their benefit. Wall Street is losing its mind, and Wall Street now wants to change the rules of the game because a bunch of people with accounts ranging from $500 to $2,500 are taking down the billionaires? Ha! Well, it looks to me like millions of average Joes are willing to lose money for the chance to short squeeze some hedge funds out of existence. Does this qualify as a populist revolt? Absolutely. Like I said before, this is the Boston Tea Party of the 21st century. But honestly, they should have seen it coming. The warning signs were all there. This was from a book written by the founder of the Wall Street Bets community, published a year ago. They become much more difficult when large groups of people make it their goal to hunt for and capitalize on exploitable weaknesses. Not to mention, share them on social media to make them go viral. To my knowledge, brokers haven't had the proper stress test to withstand stampedes of high-risk thumb traders that aren't afraid of margin calls. And here's the book, titled Wall Street Bets: How Boomers Made the World's Biggest Casino for Millennials, published just over a year ago at the time of this video. Wall Street has been borrowing money on margin and getting constant cash flow from the Fed's money printer to pump stocks since the inception of the traditional market. Meanwhile, Wall Street Bets pumps stocks with their hard-earned money. Market manipulation. The Fed pumps corporate bonds with money printed out of thin air. Ugh, monetary policy. What a racket. All because basically this happened. Robinhood traders with $600 stimmy checks versus hedge funds. That, coupled with a little Twitter trolling from now the world's richest man on earth, Elon Musk, always delivering game stonk. Awesome. So how has Wall Street's puppets, the US government, responded to the incident? Well, the Biden administration is monitoring the Wall Street bet situation. Who could have known that individual stocks flying to the moon would be the Biden administration's first national security crisis? But let's be honest. The speed in which Congress will probably pass legislation to prevent something like this GameStop thing from happening again will show you the difference between immediate for Wall Street and immediate for people waiting on those $2,000 stimulus checks. Why is it so? Well, look at this. They stopped people buying GameStop quicker than they stopped banks buying foreclosed homes in 2008. Insanity. Well, Wall Street Bets didn't stop at GameStop. They targeted a few other companies that hedge funds were heavily shorting as well, like AMC and BlackBerry. They even attempted the biggest short squeeze in the world, silver, $25 to $1,000. Silver bullion market is one of the most manipulated on earth. Any short squeeze in silver paper shorts would be epic. We know billion banks are manipulating gold and silver to cover real inflation. Both the industrial case and monetary case, debt printing has never been more favorable for the number one inflation hedge, silver. Inflation-adjusted silver should be at $1,000 instead of $25. Interesting to think about. So, what happened next? Well, Wall Street threw their weight around and called in reinforcements from their fellow corporate cronies. First, they destroyed the community's lines of communication. Discord bans Wall Street Bets server for hate speech. Oh, please. Elon Musk calling spades, saying Discord's gone corpo after it took down Wall Street Bets. And Discord wasn't the only company that went corpo. Robinhood, TD Ameritrade, restrict trading of GameStop and AMC stock. GameStop's stock price remains sky high, but shares are becoming more difficult to buy. If that's not market manipulation, I don't know what is. So if you were affected by the exchange freezing your trading activity, we are organizing a class action lawsuit to right this draconian wrong. If you're interested in more information about joining the class action lawsuit, please go to matlaw.com/class-action, or you can click on the link below in the description area of this video. As retail investors, litigation is one way we can fight back. Another way, extremely surprisingly, is some people in the US government might actually be on our side, the retail investor side, on this one. Check it out. This is unacceptable. AOC, Ted Cruz, and others side with retail investors and slam Robinhood and Wall Street amid GameStop mania. Nice. But would you actually trust US politicians as far as you can throw them? Personally, I would hold my breath on how fast they take action against Wall Street, about as long as I would hold my breath for another stimulus check. These same politicians are well aware of where all the money goes, straight into Wall Street's pocket. Wall Street has been and will continue to be first in line at the money printer. But even the chair of the Federal Reserve pretends otherwise, Jerome Powell. It's not monetary policy that's driving asset valuations. What a load of crap. And nobody even challenged him on that question. They moved on to the vaccine, to which Powell asserted, asset prices recently driven by vaccines, fiscal steps. Maybe someone can ask where the $120 billion the Fed injects every month is going then? Thanks, Wall Street, corporate America. We all know it. Not sure why all these boomers think we can't see it and continue to blatantly lie about it. Here's another boomer in a powerful position, the new Treasury Secretary, Janet Yellen. I don't see a financial crisis occurring in our lifetimes. The Fed chair on Tuesday said the country's financial sector is very much stronger than it was years ago. Get out of town. Sure, as someone in her mid-70s, it's possible she won't see one in her lifetime, but you know what she will see in her lifetime? People opting out of this corrupt, rigged racket that is and always has been traditional finance. She will see mass adoption of a new, more efficient, completely transparent, trustless, free market, inclusive of everyone on the planet, and that is decentralized finance built on blockchain technology. To learn more about blockchain technology and why the entire new, truly free, transparent global financial ecosystem will operate using it, check out my beginner's guide on what blockchain is by clicking on the link above. Following that, I suggest you watch my video guide for beginners explaining the difference between our current, corrupt, centralized financial system and the new upcoming decentralized financial ecosystem by clicking on the link above. In the current decentralized financial ecosystem built on the Ethereum network, decentralized exchanges like Uniswap can't shut down your trades and are not controlled by any one person, government, corporation, or entity whatsoever. And if you don't know what Ethereum is, prepare to have your mind blown when you watch my video guide for beginners explaining what Ethereum is by clicking on the link above. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. The Boston Tea Party just happened. We have an entire financial revolution incoming. So don't stick around while the US dollar hyperinflates into worthlessness and Wall Street continues to eat your lunch while their bought and paid for political puppets give us lip service. Opt out of a financial system that was created for the wealthy elites to profiteer from and join the financial revolution that will finally even the playing field for us all. Awesome. I hope this video helped you understand the crazy events that have unfolded so far this week. If you enjoyed the information, please make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel for more financial technology content. So what are your thoughts about the short squeeze fiasco? What other questions do you have about what happened this week? Were you affected by the exchange's freezing trading activity? If so, use the link to matlaw.com/class-action for more information about the lawsuit. Let me know what's on your mind in the comments below. Be safe out there.